Christmas is the season of joy and celebration of God's greatest gift to mankind, His Son Jesus Christ being born into this world as Emmanuel, which means God with us. Bringing hope to a world of despair, assuring each of us that He is with us at all times. But today, the pandemic has in every way torn the social fabric, causing massive despair and havoc. But history reminds us that Christians have time and time again have found consolation in the good news of the birth of Christ into a new possibility, a new hope over despair. And with a deep sense of faith, we continue to spread this joy and good news.
Shall we bow our heads in prayer? Creator God, our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you because you not only created us, but you thought of us. And so, Lord, you sent your only Son to be our Savior, our Redeemer. Lord Jesus Christ, how grateful we are to you, obeying the Father's will. You came down searching for us, sinners like us. Lord, we want to thank you for the joy of Christmas, the hope of Christ being born as our Savior, our Liberator. Lord, we thank you because you gave up your glory, heaven above, came down in a lowly manger. Lord, we thank you for you took up a lowly form, exhibited utter humility. You chose the marginalized to announce your very birth. You chose the little town of Bethlehem to be born. And you chose the swaddling clothes to be the sign of the Savior's birth. God, whose option for the poor, even as we celebrate the birth of our Savior coming into this world, help us, O Lord, amidst all the celebrations, that we would be mindful of the very meaning, the purpose of Christ coming into this world. Lord, we thank you because of the joy you wrought to us, the blessings the birth of Savior gave us, and the hope that it continues to give. Enable us, O Lord, in a very special way this year, even as we celebrate the birth of Savior amidst varied situations, discouragement, loneliness, distress, sorrows, sufferings. Help us, Lord, to understand that Christ came into this world to participate in the human suffering and to give us hope. People who are walking in darkness saw the great light. And so, Lord, help us also, even as we experience that hope and the light that shone, that we would be able to transmit the same to those whom we would come across. May your very purpose of coming into this world come to fruition in and through our lives. We want to commend this celebration, the entire Christmas service unto you. May it bring honor and glory unto your name. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Today's Bible reading is taken from Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Here ends the Bible reading.
The Word of God in Romans 6:23 says that, For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. In order to fulfill this promise, He sent His only Son to be born into this world. Long ago, when Herod was king of Judea, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth in Galilee to announce to a virgin named Mary,
Hail Mary, full of grace. Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High.
How will this be, since I am a virgin?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you, for nothing is impossible with God.
God also sent his angel to appear to Joseph in a dream, saying,
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit.
When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded and took Mary home as his wife.
Thank you.
When Mary and Joseph reached Bethlehem, the time came for the baby to be born, and Mary placed him in a manger.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over the flocks at night. They were the first to experience Jesus. In the still of the night, an angel of the Lord appeared to them.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy. For today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born, who is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
And so the words of the prophet Isaiah came to be fulfilled.
Joy to the world.
When the angels had left, the shepherds hurried off to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. The scripture tells us that the Magi from the east, who followed the guiding star to Bethlehem, came to worship the King of the Jews after his birth, bearing with them the gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Yes, the birth of the Savior is a beacon of light and hope to the dreary world even today.
Is not about a title or a designation. It's about impact, influence, and inspiration. Impact involves getting results. Influence is about spreading the passion you have for your work, and you have to inspire continually. We now have a great leader with a vision and a mission. It's our honor and privilege to invite our great leader, the Right Reverend Dr. P.K. Samuel, Bishop of Karnataka Central Diocese, to deliver the Christmas message.
Friends, I'm happy to greet you in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. A special word of appreciation and thanks to your principal, Mrs. Nyanamani Franklin, for taking all the initiative in order to have this virtual Christmas carols so that the students and the teachers would be able to enjoy all that God had done during this year. And on behalf of the Karnataka Central Diocese and the officers and the executive committee, it's my privilege and honor this evening to convey our greetings and best wishes for the season. A season which has a reason because Christ was born 2,000 years ago. And I take this time to convey our greetings. Although it is a virtual service, the carol service, and I'm sure that the staff and the students are putting their best efforts to bring in this Christmas carols. And we would like to thank the principal, the staff, and all the others for making it a meaningful Christmas time. God bless you. During the Great Depression that hit Australia in the 1930s, a family, like many families during this time, was struggling to put food on the table. Certainly, luxuries were considered a very distant dream because of the Depression. One day, there were posters pasted all over the town announcing the arrival of a circus company. Admission was advertised at just $1. That was a very big sum amount in the Depression years, and one of the boys in one of our families was really keen to go. But the father said that you have to earn the money so that you will be able to spend that $1 for the ticket to watch the circus. The young boy had never seen a circus in his lifetime, so he worked feverishly, doing all sorts of jobs to get enough funds to purchase his ticket. On the day that the circus arrived, he went to see the performers and the animals parade through town. As he watched, a clown came dancing over to him, and the boy put his ticket in the clown's hand, and then he stood on the curb and cheered the rest of the parade moved by. The youngster rushed back home to tell his parents what he had seen and how exciting the circus was. His father listened to the whole story that the boy narrated and then put his arms on the shoulder of the boy and said, "Son, you didn't see the circus, you saw just the parade." This story is very much a picture of what happens at Christmas. The commercial hype has so clouded the reason for the season that one could be forgiving or one would have forgotten thinking of Christ of Christmas. And you know, many times we think it has nothing to do with Christianity because it has become as seasonal blessings and holiday blessings, as it were, in many of the countries. But today is a time where we need to emphasize that people miss the main event, the very birth of Jesus Christ. And that's the reason why we are trying to say the reason for this season is the very birth of Christ Himself. Put simply, the reason is the very birth of Jesus Christ. When we celebrate Christmas, we are celebrating the birthday of the most important person in the human history and in the human existence. It is none other than Christ Himself. Ironically, many people who celebrate Christmas celebrate something they don't believe in or never experience the reality of the birth of Christ. Christmas of 2020 is surely different from the other Christmas that we have celebrated during our lifetime. In 2020, as all of us understand globally, and counting, about 1.2 million people have died as casualties of an invisible enemy, the COVID-19 virus. And the spread of the virus shows no signs of abating soon. The pandemic has disrupted, even destroyed, many aspects of our own lives. The lifestyle has changed. It has brought havoc on our economy, caused unprecedented jobless people, and disrupted social relations and church services, ministries, and so many people have died. Another less noted result of the pandemic is the massive increase in the number of people suffering from mental health issues. I'm not here to give you the statistics, but it's very uncommon to hear people say pandemic has left them feeling drained and exhausted, calling out to God, how long, O Lord, will this pandemic last? Despite our difficult circumstances, God is faithful. He will never leave us nor forsake us. Jesus Christ, whose birth we celebrate on Christmas, knew everything that we were going through. He knew poverty, he knew suffering, betrayal and humiliation. He willingly gave his life on the cross, and right now he is interceding for his people and suffering along with us during this pandemic season. Because of him, we too can experience some respite and fellowship this Christmas. We remember his birth and the hope that his birth can give to humankind. Remember the angels coming down from the heavens above, looking at the shepherds and said, do not be afraid. And this was the message given many centuries ago. But they were waiting. Waiting was painful. Waiting was not that easy for the people of God. And they were waiting for a Messiah to come. Remember how long God's faithful remnant had waited for this Messiah to come. It had been a millennium since great King David and God's promise to raise up a ruler in his own line who would establish his throne forever. It had been 7 centuries since Isaiah prophesied, saying, Emmanuel, God with us, and the virgin, and the child, and the son given with garment on his shoulders, and his name called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Even after Malachi and the closing of the Hebrew canon, God's people had waited for another 400 years. No one expected such divine forbearance. No one thought that it would be so many centuries of waiting after this Messiah has been promised. People waited for the prophecy to be fulfilled, and it was fulfilled in the very birth of Jesus Christ. And it is for us today, in the uncertainties, in all the things that is camouflaging our own lives, am I in a position to recognize this Christ who came in the form of a human being, took the birth in Bethlehem, an unknown place? And am I in a position to recognize? Or are we still waiting because of the programs and the activities that we have had and planned? And if Christ is the reason for this season, what exactly we seek? Your level of joy at Christmas is directly related to what exactly you're seeking in your life. You should ask this question: what is it that I want to get out of Christmas? What is it that will make your Christmas wonderful and satisfying? All the family getting together and being happy, a feeling you define as a holiday spirit, finding the right present to give to people around, getting the present you have been hoping for. And you know, you name it, and you have so many things happening around this birthday of Jesus Christ. The problem is not Christmas. It is in our expectations. We are looking for wrong thing. And I just would like to remind you, the 3 wise men show us as to how to increase our levels of joy at this Christmas time. Very specially keeping at the background of this COVID-19 pandemic all over the world. And we need to look at the right thing. And their question was, where is he who has been born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and we have come to worship him. They were looking for Jesus, which means to say that Christmas for them was an opportunity to come closer to the baby Jesus and to worship. This is what we need to be looking for and expecting this Christmas, an experience of worshiping, a fresh glimpse of he who was born King of the Jews. If our goal this Christmas is to worship Jesus, then I doubt very seriously we'll be dissatisfied with our experience because our expectations are something different. May I remind you that if you need to seek Christ, you need to seek Christ in the right place so that you will be able to worship and receive all the blessings of this Christ child being born, and he will be able to allow you to worship, and there will be happiness and joy. It is not only where do I seek, it is where do I look. Your level of joy at Christmas is directly related to where exactly you look for the joy to increase. Again, going back to the three wise persons, we learn from the Magi that there are wrong and right places to look for Christmas. They started by looking in the wrong place. They looked at where their own human reasoning said they should be. The human reasoning said a king to be born, so he will be born in the palace. So they are searching for the Herod's palace, the great capital in the city of Jerusalem. But what mistake that was. When Herod heard of the birth of a new king, he was so jealous. And he said, I need to destroy another king in my kingdom. We too are tempted to look for joy at Christmas in wrong places. We think by getting or giving the right gift, we'll be satisfied. The three wise persons looked in the right place when they looked to God. The angel appeared and they diverted their ways to a different place and not back to Herod's palace. The trip to Jerusalem was not a total loss for them. Well, they discovered where they should have looked in the first place. And you, for you and me, it is the Bible where you need to look for that great happiness, for that consolation, for the great comfort, and for the great way, because He is the way, the truth, and the life. Thirdly, I seek and I worship. I knock at the wrong door, but God guides me to the right place. And when I come there, what do I give? Your level of joy during this Christmas directly related to what exactly you give. As you go back to the three wise persons, or the Magi, as you might call, they came and bearing gifts. The gifts they gave were entirely appropriate. When I say entirely appropriate, they were able to recognize Jesus as the King of Kings, and they gave gold. And they also recognized Jesus as the High Priest. They gave frankincense. While they recognized the High Priest and the King, they also recognized a king who has come with the only purpose of dying for the people of God, dying for the whole world. And they gave myrrh. And this is applied only for the dead persons. This was a fragrant or ointment used to anoint a body before the burial. So here was a king, here was a high priest, here was a person who was going to die. And you know, the whole thing came to be given to Jesus, foretelling that He is a Messiah who has come down to complete the prophecies that has been foretold in the Old Testament. Let's not keep our eyes on trees and stores, but let's keep our eyes on the one who came as a baby to set the captives free, to extend all grace and to bring joy to people. So keeping Christ in Christmas is less about the external and more about internal. Our internal beliefs and our reliance on Christ will determine whether Christ really is in our Christmas this year or not. This is a birthday celebration that faithfully summons Christians each year to recognize and give thanks for Christ's love for us and His grace, His forgiveness, His supreme sacrifice that He made on the cross, and thank God for His resurrection. I am reminded of a carol, a hymn. Love came down at Christmas, love all lovely, love divine. Love was born at Christmas, stars and angels gave the sign. A very familiar carol. And if you have a chance to help those homeless people anywhere in your own places, to find some joy and peace at Christmas, sing along with these people. And the song goes like this: if I can help somebody as I pass along, if I can cheer somebody with a word or song, if I can show somebody how they are traveling wrong, then my living shall not be in vain. These lyrics and the other lyrics that can bring memories of Jesus' birth thousands of years ago. And the Christmas carols represent the real reason of this season, as many words would be able to tell us. It's my prayer and wish today, virtually, as you look up to the various activities of your own institutions, may God's name be glorified, and may you receive double portion of God's blessings as you understand the reason as to why Christ came down to this world.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, as we come to a close, Jesus is still our Emmanuel, giving us that hope to meet the pressures of life. As our hopes and dreams may collapse, God assures us that He is ever present and would dispel the darkness. So let us entrust our entire lives into His hands despite uncertainties as we celebrate this Christmas. Thank you.
The roots of all goodness lie in the soil of appreciation. Good morning, Mannal. I am honored to present the vote of thanks on this memorable occasion. First and foremost, I would like to thank God Almighty for His abundant grace and mercy that made this program a great success. I thank our Bishop, Right Reverend Dr. Prasanna Kumar Samil, for his inspiring message that brought us the real meaning of this festive season. His prayers and support uphold our school in more ways than one. His presence brought us the Christmas spirit of this season. I thank our board members for their presence and their constant guidance towards the school and for being here today to celebrate with us. I would like to thank all the teachers who took the time to participate in today's program and showcase their talent. Despite practicing only for a day, the program was a great success due to your hard work and dedication. A special thanks to those who helped us in recording this technical part of this program, without whom this program would surely not be possible. Thank you for your coordination and all your assistance. Thanks to all the parents, students and well-wishers watching online in the comfort of your homes and for your support. Once again, I thank all of you for your support and participation. It was a delight to celebrate the season of love and joy with each one of you. Continue to keep our institution in your prayers. Wishing you all a blessed season of Christmas and a joyous new year. Thank you.
Let us bow our heads for God's prayer. Gracious Heavenly Father, we gather together in your presence this noon with a thankful heart. Lord, we thank for your blessing of our food, water, and healing. We are all encouraged by your promises each day. Lord, you are our sustainer, God, renew our faith in you. We pray for the intervention in all our sickness and struggles, especially in day-to-day activities of our school. Lord, we commit ourselves for your purpose more than our situation which we go through. Lord, we look forward behind the boundaries and the challenges and act as an instrument to reflect your glory in this Christmas season. Lord, you are our shield. We take refuge in you. Deliver us from all evil. We beseech you to renew your spirit and fill us with all your peace and unending joy. This we pray in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you, with the unity of the Holy Spirit as one God, now and forever. Amen.
With confidence and boldness, let us receive God's blessings. Unto God's gracious mercy and protection, we commit you. The blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you, very especially during this festive season and in the year to come, with all His blessings, both now and forevermore.
Amen. Merry Christmas.